I'm saying God told me, leave those people behind that you got to convince. I don't got to tell you why we got to convince people who've been reading the word. Why we got to convince people who've been in the church their whole life. Why we got to convince people who've seen the power of God over and over again. Why we got to keep convincing. It's time to move forward. We ain't got a lot of time on this earth to be having meetings that at the end of the meeting don't nothing come out of it. I don't even care if we met for 4 hours and something came from it. We meeting and ain't nothing coming from it but bad feelings. It's homeless people. It's people with mental disorders. It's kids trying to go to college. We still living from check to check. You've been paying tithe for how long? It's time to move forward. You've been paying tithes for how long? You had that gift for how long? It's time to move forward. God is ashamed of most of us in this room. Now, I can't speak for all y'all. He told me, I'm ashamed of you. This man just did an app and it's got 80 million people following. What would happen if you did something for me and 80 million people gave their life to me, son? You still going to non-believers to push your message. Why you ain't got your own? Why you keep saying, oh God, if I say too much Jesus, they're going to shut me down. They shouldn't be able to shut you down. You should have your own stuff. You keep putting your stuff on their stuff and crying about what they doing to your stuff. Get your own stuff. We talk about people who got stuff who ain't even got God like we got God, and they got more stuff than we do. They got more faith. They moving further than we moving. I brought a treat. Forward. Say it with me. 1, 2, 3. Please do me a favor. Write in your phone before you leave. What do you need to go forward in? Why don't y'all, as anointed as you are, why don't your bank account look like it? As anointed as we are, why don't your credit score look like the God that you serve? What's the problem? Why aren't our relationships, why aren't we producing? We're not going forward. We just want to be here. No, we no more of that. No more of the coasting. No more coasting. No more settling. No more going in circles. We going forward, or you ain't going with me. You be like, listen to me, and I ain't mad at you, but you can have your little settling party. Settle, if you will, if you must. I'm not mad at you. It's safer. You don't want this life. You don't want this life. This life, God get to tell you what you want, what he wants you to do every day. You don't want this life. You don't want God to tell you when he wants you to wake up. Go ahead and keep you wake up at 9 every day self, and you ain't going to get up. No, I don't wake up before 9. Okay, I don't know what God you serve. I don't serve a God who on my schedule. Sometimes he want to use me at 3 a.m. Sometimes he want to use me at 3 p.m. Sometimes he want me to go to a restaurant and get terrible service so I can leave and then come back and get what I was supposed to get in the first place, and that ain't breakfast. Miss what I just said though. The only reason I called homegirl wasn't even breakfast, but it was being obedient to my wife. Bro, you still tripping on why your marriage ain't, you giving 60%. How dare you want 120 when you giving 60? There's a part in the Bible that says, whatever you do, do it with excellence. And some of us are not financially where we're supposed to be because you are working, but it's 80%. Listen to me, do me a huge favor. Don't go with all the word says or don't go with it at all. Don't be a skeptic. It's not worth it. So I'm talking to this billionaire yesterday, and he like, E, I see what you're doing, but you need to take it to the next level. You know what I'm saying? Hey, everything he was saying was dope until he started saying, but if I'm going to help you, I'm going to need to see your financial records. I was like, oh. He was like, yeah, how much did you make? I told him. He's like, okay, good. Send me the bank statements. It's like, whoa, bank statement. Like, bro, this is our first conversation. Like, our real first conversation. Like, you ain't even here. You on Zoom. Like, my man started asking some serious stuff. And God says, hold up. What you doing? Why are you skeptical? You call him. He ain't calling you.
He
didn't call you. You call him. He didn't ask for your help. You asked for his. So if you're really trying to go to the next level, if you bought that life, get a man what he asked for. or stop wasting his time. But there is no growth in fear. There is no growth in scared. There is no growth. Why are you calculating something you can't calculate? Why are you sitting here, people of God, trying to calculate with the Messiah? Why are you trying to collect? He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. If he tells you to do something, do it. You ain't got to calculate it. You couldn't if you wanted to.